The brain has very little ability to survive without oxygen. It undergoes permanent damage when there is any limitation of blood flow to any parts of it. The condition that happens when you have a limitation to blood supply to any part of the brain is a stroke, and everybody understands what a stroke is. What they don't understand is that it's as important for a patient who has stroke-like symptoms to get himself or herself to a hospital as it is for him or her to get to the hospital when they have chest pain because of the heart. Because the same principles apply there, the sooner blood flow is restored to the brain, the better, the lesser will be the damage in the long run. Unlike the heart, a stroke even to a small part of the brain can have devastating consequences. A small hit can cause a very large damage as far as weakness and stroke-like symptoms are concerned. So you don't need to have a massive stroke to cause a significant damage to the body. The heart, on the other hand, the more damage there is to the muscle, the worse the situation is going to be. So you can get away with a heart attack and have a practically normal lifespan and quality of life. If the person is lucky enough to have a small heart attack in, say, the bottom portion of the heart, they may get away with it not even knowing about it. But the brain, on the other hand, is a lot less forgiving.